Are you somebody who's afraid to go to the chiropractor, but you won't think twice about asking a friend or a family member to crack your back? I have to tell you the story of David. I've known David through the community for about a year now. He's a local tattoo artist, so he's constantly bending forward, hunched over his work all day long. And then he draws a lot, so even in his spare time, he's in that same position. He started to have a lot of mid and lower back stiffness, and then it just started to concentrate up into his mid back. And about a week ago, the pain got so bad that he asked a friend of his to crack his back. So David described it to me like this. He said for whatever reason, he laid down on the bench and he had his hand in a fist just like this right up on his chest. And he laid down, he had this hand dangling over the side. And his friend pushed on him so hard, he said he heard a crack that was so loud that he'd never heard anything like that before. So he stood up and he said he felt the blood rush from his head all the way down to his toes, and he went back onto the bench and he blacked out. He said he was blacked out for about 30 seconds, and then he was really lightheaded and just a little bit disoriented. So he reached out to me a couple of days ago and asked me what I thought, and I said, we need to get an x-ray of this. So David came in today, and we took an x-ray, and it's just what I suspected. He has 3 rib fractures. He had his hand here, and the way his friend, the force that his friend pushed on him was just enough to fracture 3 ribs. Now, you might be afraid to go to the chiropractor, but when you come to the chiropractor, we are far more strategic about the way we adjust people. So David was actually really happy that he came to me. He wished he would have come to me before that happened, but he said, no way, he will never do that again. And he will tell as many people as he can to not have friends and family crack their backs, because now he's in a lot of pain and he's going to have that level of discomfort for at least 8 to 12 weeks until these bones heal. So we're going to adjust around them for him. We're going to bring relief to his spine, try to balance out everything we can up above the fracture and below the fracture so that his body can have as much power as it needs to get itself to heal. Chiropractors aren't really a scary place because we take the time to evaluate each and every patient. We take x-rays in this office so I can see things like a fractured rib or a degenerative disc or some other anomaly that I might not be able to glean that is there if I didn't have an x-ray. And then being super strategic about how we adjust and what techniques we need to use to make sure that we're realigning the spine properly to give you the best possible chance of healing that we possibly can. So the next time you're thinking, maybe I should ask a friend or a family member to crack my back, I will tell you to think twice and call your local chiropractor and get it evaluated. If you're having pain so badly that you feel like it needs to be cracked, then hire a professional. David had said to me, his first mistake was laying down on the table with his hand like this. And I joked with him and I said, no, actually, your first mistake was not having a professional adjust you. And he laughed. He said, that's fair. And I said, listen, if I ever decide I want a tattoo and I take a ballpoint pen and I just start jamming it into my skin and then I go, it didn't turn out to be a pretty picture, can you fix it? And he started laughing. So I said, I'm going to hire the professional to do a tattoo, not somebody who has zero knowledge in what is going on. And this goes for anything. If you want the job done, you could hire anybody. But if you want it done right and done well, you will hire the professional. Please share this with someone you know who is always asking people, hey, can you crack my back? And let them know there is a better way. As always, I appreciate you being here, and I look forward to seeing you on the next one.